Hello, my name's Eric Smith, and I'm the Artistic Director of the American Baroque Opera Company. Welcome to our ABOC at Home series 2020 with our production of Delaguerre's Le Sommeil d'Ulysses. Composed around 1715, this work was written by Elizabeth Jacquet Delaguerre, one of the few female composers who gained fame during her time. After listening to today's music, it's easy to see why there's a resurgence in interest in her music. Today's production brings an exciting collaboration with Indique Dance Company, a group that blends beautifully classical Indian dance with modern dance styles. As many Baroque opera fans will know, hand gesture is very important in the storytelling of Baroque opera. And in today's production, we'll highlight that similarity with classical Indian dance. So sit back and let us tell you a tale of the great Ulysses at sea.
Thank you. Thank you. To it. Is it classical Indian dance? Indian mm-hmm. classical dance?
Indian classical.
Indian classical dance?
Yes.
I don't know. How do you even start this?
Hi, guys.
Hi.
How are you doing?
This may seem like a really unusual pairing with Indian classical dance and French Baroque opera. However, there are a lot of similarities in Baroque gesture and Indian dance gesture that we were really enjoying seeing the parallels between the two, and they just seem like a perfect marriage.
When we started working on this, we were like, hey, we're getting to explore. We usually have 9 rasas, they are called, 9 emotions that we play with. I mean, we love that. That's a big part of facial expressions, body expressions, and mm-hmm. I think we got to explore pretty much
every emotion.
Yeah. Starting from the first piece, there was There was love, there was disgust, there was
anger,
there was sadness. It was like a good blend of all the nine emotions, the Navarasas, as we call them.
And the Navarasas, there are nine, and rasa is basically if you take a fruit and you juice it, and you get the sweetest part of that fruit. That's what ras means, like the sweetest part of the fruit. So you're giving the sweetest part of the emotion, the core of that emotion, and you're trying to give that to the rasika, and the rasika are your audience members, and you want them to leave, or you know, just anybody who's even listening to music, they don't need to be in your audience, and you want them to leave with a feeling of whatever emotion you're exploring or trying to express. So if you have a piece that's very angry, you want them to leave thinking, why am I feeling angry? Or, you know, or joyful. So at the end of this, you know, the last piece that you all gave us, we call it a tilana, because that's how we conclude.
It's the finale. Usually when we do a program, we mostly end it with the tilana. Mm-hmm. And we always called that a tilana because we felt joy. We felt like it was the finale, so.
In Baroque gesture, there's some very distinct gestures that, mm-hmm. that audiences would pick up on,
right.
Like flame or the right side being all things positive and happy and the left side being something that's negative or mm-hmm. unpleasant. So you cast someone to hell or you summon a goddess or something like that. Mm-hmm. What are some of the things that we got to see?
So we have hand gestures which we call mudras. And just single-handed itself, we have 28. And those hand gestures, each of them have a meaning. Each mudra or each hand gesture has a meaning. So for instance, when we were showing the ocean, we would show waves with a hand gesture. Or if we were showing anger, or we would show a mudra. And so you cannot just have a mudra and have an expression. So with that, you have to add that one of the Navarasas to create the emotion, to bring that mudra or the hand gesture to life. You can't just do a mudra and there's no life in that. You have to add expression. That's why we have both expression and mudras that bring the feeling to life.
I was going to show the boat because the very beginning we start with him coming on the boat. And so here again we are using, like she was saying, we use the mudras, but then our face is telling the story of wait, am I, you know, what am I seeing, what am I experiencing, what's going on. So we get to use the emotion and then we get to use these hand gestures.
It is very good. Was it difficult for you when you were choreographing this to use French Baroque music?
You know, I think because the music has so much feeling, it was actually so beautiful. And then we had the script,
yes,
which told us the story.
Really helped, yeah.
And then we did a little bit more research and just kind of understanding who the characters were, because we would do that in our stories, whether they were Hindu mythology or, you know, basic. We do a lot of dances that are based on true life stories, so then we research that. So it's just, we love to research.
And we got a lot of parallels also when mm-hmm. we were doing,
yeah.
you know, this all these pieces. We were like, wait, this reminds me of this dance. Mm-hmm. Hey, we did this, you know, something similar. So we got a lot of parallel stories that we mm-hmm. thought about,
yes.
and I think that also helped us choreograph. And we loved choreographing for this one. It was such a beautiful journey for us, I think, the last. Do we need anything else?
That was beautiful. That was five strikes.
Oh, okay. Woo!